And there are a lot of problems, you know, clearly marked. They are all very visible here in India, right? You just, all you have to do is just even crossing the street can be a challenge sometimes, right? But what it also means is that there are that many opportunities for each of you to address. You don't have to look at everything as a problem. Think of it like an opportunity. Now, in some cases, there are opportunities that are big enough where you can actually create a business and become an entrepreneur. But in a lot of places, you know, even if you, it doesn't take much to solve that. So in a way, Kakatiya sandbox it's really a bottom-up form of socio-economic development. First principle is charity per se doesn't work as well. So how do you bring the entrepreneurial mindset, the principles of business to address social challenges? Second, it's a bottom-up socio-economic development. So unless the local people, especially the young people like each of you, so almost all our programs are, again, if they are successful, it's because of engaging the young people like each of you. Again, then sandbox, which I won't get into too much detail right now, but then Komatireddy garu annattu, we have a lot of programs with farmers. In fact, ippude nenu, I was in that, so we met you know, some of the farmers there, and we are doing few different things. One is for cotton crops are pretty big, so cotton crops, there are better practices by which you can increase the productivity, almost doubling the income levels. And there is something called farm ponds, and it's again, water is one of the most important elements that determines the outcome, productivity for farmers. Now, it's good to have the farmers working with us in that, but the reason why that's working is because of people like Srinivas and the other, you know, young people, Vamshi, you know, these are the people that are actually going, they're just like each of you. All of them, I mean, they're maybe in their final year of college or just graduated. So these sort of transformations in the long term can happen only if we can engage each of you successfully. And important, overall, you're in a very unique place today. So much of the world's attention is on India. A lot of the world's attention is on India. You know, there are, she was talking about my background. Hitachi bought my company about 6-7 years ago, and I'm mostly in advisory role on the board of some of the Hitachi companies. Hitachi, first time in their 100-year history, they had a board meeting outside Japan. And you know where they had the board meeting? It's a $100 billion company. You can imagine how big that is, right? They had the board meeting here in India, not in US or in China. Again, and I'm just giving that as one example of several why India is increasingly becoming so important to people in America. Of course, in Israel, that's where our prime minister is now, or will be, I guess, starting today or tomorrow. So, you know, all over the world. So, Meeru, growing up in India, this is a very different India that you are growing up in. When we were growing up, India was always considered to be like a basket case or country with, you know, who can't get their act together. But that's not the perception that India has today. And within India, you're in a place like this where you have access to, you know, different people, thanks to people like Komatireddy and, you know, Sandeep and other startups start coming here. I mean, it's phenomenal, the kind of exposure that you have. So try to take advantage, every advantage that you can, you know, for such opportunities. But in the end, the country needs more job creators right now. You know, we have about 1 million people like you every year that are coming into the work, every month that are coming into the workforce, right? So we need jobs for all of these people. The government is not going to be the answer to that. I mean, government can only create the right ecosystem, hopefully, to, you know, for private enterprises to flourish. So I'm hoping that many of you will actually become entrepreneurs at some point in your life. Obviously, first foremost important thing is